Very good morning, all of you. In yesterday's session, we discussed Gauss quadrature two-point formula and Gauss quadrature three-point formula. And in that, we discussed the formulae associated with it. So equation number two will give you the formula that is used for Gauss quadrature two-point formula. And equation three is the Gauss quadrature three-point formula. So here one thing I would like to mention, when a question is asked in the examination, you need to use these two formulae while solving the problem. Okay, but when you are going to program the same, for example, Gauss quadrature two-point formula, then you may need to use a different equation. And ultimately, the final equation, that is equation 2 and 3, are derived from the equation that we will discuss today. But yes, when you go to the these equation, the equation that we will discuss today, it will be easier for you to program the same. Okay, so with this, we will start our session. So in this particular session, we will see Gauss quadrature two-point formula and a different equation, set of equations, I would say, that we will see. Then we will prepare a flowchart by using the process that we adopted for solving Gauss quadrature two-point formula. And then we will try to run the write the code in the Python and run the same. So this is the general structure of any integration equation. I is equal to integration a to b f of x dx. In Gauss quadrature 2-point and 3-point formula, we saw that we need integration values between minus 1 and 1. So that is not the case in this case. But even though integration limits are not minus 1 to 1, we can still solve this particular problem by using Gauss quadrature 2-point formula. Just we need to adopt a different methodology. So what we need to do? We need to use this particular formula. The equation is I equal to B minus A upon 2 W1 F of X1 plus W2 F of X2, where B is upper limit, A is lower limit. Now in this equation, there are four unknowns: W1, W2, F of X1 and F of X2. So in order to calculate the value of x1, so we use this formula. X1 is equal to b minus a upon 2 z1 plus b plus a upon 2. And in order to calculate the value of x2, we use formula b minus a upon 2 into z2 plus b plus a upon 2. But again, question arises, W1 is unknown, W2 is unknown, and again Z1 and Z2, these are the two new additional unknown. So in case of Gauss quadrature 2-point formula, we take W1 equal to W2 equal to 1. So we received the values of W1 and W2. Similarly, in order to calculate the value of Z1, you can take Z1 equal to minus 1 upon square root of 3. And for Z2, we take the value as 1 upon square root of 3. So this is how we can solve the given integration problem by Gauss quadrature 2-point formula, even though the integral limits are not between minus 1 and 1. So this is the process that we need to adopt. Now what we will do, we will take one example and apply this formula and solve it. So the problem is, using the three-point Gauss quadrature formula, evaluate integration 0 to 1 dx upon 1 plus x. So the lower limit is 0, so it is equal to a. Upper limit is 1, so b equal to 1. And the function f of x is, can be taken from this as fx is equal to 1 upon 1 plus x. So let's call it as equation number 1. So we have now values of a, b and equation for f of x.
And this particular formula is there for Gauss quadrature Gauss quadrature 2-point formula. Okay, then the value of W1 and W2 equal to 1, which is known to us. Z1 equal to minus 1 upon square root of 3, Z2 is equal to 1 upon square root of 3. Then we will use this formula to calculate the value of X1, B minus A upon 2, Z1 plus B plus A upon 2. And in the given problem, B is equal to 1, A is equal to 0, then Z1 is minus 1 upon square root of 3. And again, you can put all the values into this equation. And when you put all these values, you will get the value of X1 as 0.2113. So this is how we can calculate the values of X1. And similarly, value of X2, which is equal to B minus A upon 2, Z2 plus B plus A upon 2, where B is 1, A is 0, Z2 is 1 upon square root of 3. And also put the value of A and B in the remaining part of the equation. And simplify the same. When you simplify, you will get X2 as 0.7887. So now you have value of X1, X2. So we can put those values in equation number 1. When you put those values X1 and X2 in equation number 1, you will get the values of F of X1 and F of X2. Similarly, W1 and W2 are equal to 1. So W1 is 1, W2 is 2. B is known to us, A is also known to us. Now we can use equation number 2 to calculate the integral value. So here you can see we put all the values in equation number 2, and when you put and simplify those equation, you will get integration answer as 0.6923. So this is how we use Gauss quadrature 2-point formula to calculate the integral value of a given equation. Now we understood the step-by-step procedure to calculate the answer. Now we will try to prepare a flow chart by using the steps that we discussed in this method. So the first step is we need to read the problem carefully, try to understand. And again, as we know, we have decided to solve the problem in Python. So the first step will be, of course, we will start the suitable package of Python. Then next step, what we do from given problem, we write equation F of X and the value of A and B. So in flowchart, first of all, in Python, we will define function F of X as 1 upon 1 plus X. And also we will enter the value of A and B manually. So this is the third step. Then for Gauss quadrature 2-point formula, these values are known, W1, W2, Z1 and Z2, these values are known. What you need to do, you need to just enter those values into the Python program. So W1 equal to W2 equal to 1 and Z1 and Z2 we will put. That will be the step number 4. Then by using the above values, we can calculate the value of X1 and X2. So, and for those, we will use those equations. So you need to write a code in the Python in order to calculate the value of X1 and X2. Then once you calculate X1 and X2, now all the unknowns from this equation are now available with you. So put those values and calculate the answer of the integration, and which is 0.6923. And in Python, we will calculate integration I is equal to B minus A upon 2 into bracket W1 F of X1 plus W2 F of X2. And we will print the final answer that we received here. and that will be the end of the program. So now what we will do, we will try to write a code in the Python and run the same, and we will also check whether we are getting this particular answer or not. Okay, so please anybody confirm that you can see my screen as well.
Yes sir, it's visible.
So as you can you see my screen?
Yes sir, it's visible.
Yes, anybody? Hello? Yes, great. Okay, thank you. So yeah, so as we know that I am using Jupyter notebook for Python code. Already installed Jupyter notebook, but yeah, as I told you, you can use Colab or any other suitable tool. As I have already seen that many students are using different platforms for using Python, so you can use whatever you can do. Okay, it will take some time to open because the system is a little bit slow. Meanwhile, if you have any question, you can ask to me, or even after writing the code, you can ask the question, no problem. Okay, so a localhost window will open. You need to click on new, then Python 3. Okay, so we will start here. So the first step was to start the Python, so we did it. Now second step is to define function f of x, so which is 1 upon 1 plus x. So that we will do now. So before that, we will import some library, for example, math. Then we will also import NumPy as np. So sometimes these libraries are required during the execution of the program, so we're just importing it. And now we will define function f of x. So def space f of x then colon, and it will return a equation 1 upon 1 plus x. Yesterday when I was working on this program, by mistake I didn't put this bracket, and I was not getting the answer, and I was struggling a lot why I'm not getting the correct answer. So mistakes are very silly, but that will become hectic when you didn't get the correct answer. Okay, so we will assign this equation 1 upon 1 plus x to f of x. Now in latter part of the program we can use it. Then read value of a and b. So for this particular problem, a is 0 and b is 1. Okay, so
sir, that is equal to
data
x.
Type we will define as float.
Excuse me, sir.
And then input. And here enter lower limit of the integration as a. So why we are doing this? The answer is very simple, that we want to enter the lower limit of the integration and upper limit of the integration into output window. That's why I'm using this particular command line. So enter upper limit of the as b. And what you need to do here, you need to write the content. For example, the quoted statement, enter the lower limit of the integration as a and b. So you need to write in a such a way that it should be self-explanatory. why it is essential when you long write a very long program, then and when it is required to enter so many values in the output window, so at that time there may be a problem and you may not understand which value you have to enter. So whatever you are writing inside the code, that should be self-explanatory, so that in the output window you will come to know which value you have to enter. This is called a self-explanatory program. Okay, then we entered value of a and b, then we need to enter the value of w1 w2 z1 and z2. So that part we will do now. So w1 is equal to 1, w2 equal to 1, then z1 is equal to, let me check the equation, -1 upon square root of 3 minus 1 upon math dot sqrt 3. Yeah, so for square root we will use the math function and the sqrt, then z2 is equal to 1 upon math dot sqrt. Yeah, z1 is equal to -1 upon square root of 3 and z2 is equal to 1 upon square root of 3. Okay, so we entered w1, w2, z1, z2. Yes. Now we will calculate x1 and x2 by using this formula. X1 is b minus a upon 2 z1 plus b plus a upon 2. Okay, so let's try. X1 is equal to b minus a upon 2 and multiplied by z1 plus b plus a divided by 2. I guess I write the equation correctly. Okay, b minus a upon 2 into z1. Similarly, we will write the equation for x2 as well. So again, x2 is equal to b minus a upon 2 z2 and b plus a upon 2. I hope I wrote the equations correctly. And what you can also do additionally, you can write a print statement for x1 and x2, so that if you did any mistake in the calculation of x1 and x2 at output window, the value will be displayed and you will understand. So that I can, additional lines I am writing actually. Okay, and similarly I will write a print statement for x2 as well. These things are essential, especially when you are writing long programs and you want to check where is the exact error is. Okay, so we calculated x1 and x2. Now we will calculate integration. So I is equal to b minus a upon 2 w1 f of x1 plus w2 f of x2. So I will try to write that. So I is equal to b minus a upon 2 multiplied by into bracket w1, then f of x1 plus w2 f of x2. Okay, the b minus a upon 2 into w1 f of x1 plus w2 f of x2. I hope I wrote it correctly. Now we will print those values, print the value of integration. So print the solution, the integration problem is then we will write here I. Okay, so yes, we wrote the equation for calculating this integration I, and we also write the statement to print the value. And now next step is to run the program and try to find out if there is any mistake if you did during the process. Okay, so what is happening? Yeah. Enter the lower limit of the integration as a. So line number 5 is executing. So for given problem, the lower limit was 0. Enter the upper limit of the integration. Line number 6 is executing. Upper limit is 1. And here the value of x1 is 0.2113. x2 is 0.7886. So let's check. Yeah, this seems correct. This is also correct. Okay, but the solution of the integration is 3. And we got different answers. So up to x2, the program is correct. In latter Hello, part, there is some mistake. So that you need to check carefully. So can anybody help? What mistake probably I did? Yes, anybody?
Hello, sir.
B minus.
अरे सर ने त्यांचा पीसीचा वॉइस काही हे केला म्हणून आपल्याला आपलं काही सरांना ऐकू जात नाहीये. पीसीचा व्हॉल्यूम 0 आहे सरच्या.
W1 f of x1 plus W2 f of x2. The equation I entered was incorrect. Okay. So A is 0, B is 1. Yes, now you can see what mistake I did. Instead of 1, I have wrongly entered as A. So that was the mistake here. And that's why it was taking the value of A, which we were entering at line number 5. So such type of silly mistakes may be done by you or me. So we should be careful about it. Now we are getting answer up to so many decimals. So you can modify the program to get accuracy of the answer up to 4 or 5 decimal point. So that you can do. So that's it from my side for today's session. If you have any question, the session is open for discussion. Yes, anybody has any question?